Secondly, is resuscitation artifacts here, any injection marks over injection marks of resuscitation usually found on cardiac region as well as on extremities. And if we take this example as an extremity, you can able to see multiple injection marks over the region and over the cubital region. And if an autopsy surgeon sees, yes, you can come to a conclusion, yes, there have been some atoms that have been made, and wherein we can able to see multiple injection prick marks, and the differential diagnosis is should be of if an, he also could be an a drug abuser. And how to differentiate is if the person has been a drug abuser, the we can get an a history from the relatives, secondly from the police officer, thirdly if officer of drug abuser, there will be a poor oral hygiene as well as the dental hygiene of the person may be poor, and individual may be emaciated, thin build individual. And not only this site, we can able to see other concealed part of the body parts may show injection prick marks. And how to these are the measures by which we can able to differentiate an resuscitation injection prick mark from the abuser. And for example, the other issue arises, right? If an intracath, right, intracath or intracath material that have been used to infuse IV fluids and other, if it has been left in situ, then this issue may not occur, right? And one such line from the previous chapters, anesthetic and operative deaths, we come across one such line wherein the IV cannulas and other devices which have been used, right, like catheters or any intubation tubes that have been used in, should be left in situ, right? So if those measures have been adopted, the autopsy surgeon will not break his head, right? And secondly, any intracardiac injections, right, the underlying soft tissue, especially the heart, may show features of contusion. And if there have been multiple attempts or there have been an injury wherein a blood may ooze out and it can collect within the pericardium. And sometimes injection marks may also be associated with postmortem bruises. Defibrillator injuries, as a measure of resuscitation, wherein defibrillators have been used, and when it been applied over the chest region, may produce ring like contusions, and superficial skin burns can resemble the shape of the conductive material, and the underlying skeletal muscles wherein they undergo necrosis as a result of transthoracic defibrillators that have been used in. Classically seen over the anterior chest region and more towards left side of the chest, and you can here you can able to make out the shape of a conductive material that has been used in. And even a laryngoscope that have been used for an intubation can lead to injuries over the oral mucosa, the posterior pharynx, and larynx and other regions may show features of erosion or features of injuries as a result of usage of laryngoscope. And thirdly, towards external massage and vigorous resuscitation that have been adopted. And vigorous resuscitation, extreme application of forces during massages as a part of resuscitation can lead to bruising of anterior chest wall and hemorrhages within the subcutaneous layers of tissues. And even the pectoral muscles, it may be symmetrical and parasternal fractures of several ribs, and as well as in extreme forces where even fractures of sternum can occur in. Sternum fractures are more likely to occur if there have been vigorous resuscitation measures that have been adopted, or an external cardiac massage that have been done so. And more commonly, sternum fractures may be seen on the middle part of the body of the sternum and the manubrium part of the sternum.